in the Ivans, so you've got to keep it fluid.
Dartmouth, on Devon's south coast. A picturesque port deeply drenched in maritime history. And for a few days every summer, it's home to one of the county's most regal rendezvous. Dartmouth Royal Regatta. Sat in stately splendour across the River Dart from its twin, King's Weir, for centuries, Dartmouth was a vital naval port. But nowadays, the leisure boats are of foremost importance. Steamboat enthusiast Nigel Cooper, up from Cornwall, is a regular regatta romantic, and he's on his way to compete in one of the calendar's most prestigious floating pageants.
It's peaceful, isn't it? It's just a gentle click of a steam engine rather than the scream of an outboard.
Nigel's steaming down the River Dart to join up with his fellow sailors and to show off his steamboat, Halcyon. His chuffing and puffing pride and joy. This 1920s beaut was refitted as a steamer in the 80s.
I am proud of having a very pretty boat, and it encouraged me to keep it the same way.
Halcyon has been a prize participant at the regatta, winning the title of best steamer twice in the past. There's been a royal regatta held in Dartmouth since 1834. And it's continued to attract a fine flotilla of craft and crew ever since. This year, in the steamboat class, Nigel is jockeying for position with eight other contenders. And making sure everything is shipshape involves a careful eye for detail.
It is never-ending polishing. You managed to get most of the salt off with a damp cloth. And now we're just trying to put the shine back on the funnel. And a lot of other brass bits.
With such a collection of temperamental machinery, most deserve a medal just for getting here.
Headley, how are you getting on?
We just stopped right in front of the ferry. It's the little end bearing of the high pressure.
Take the engine out and start again. What makes these great events is what you see. There's a bit of competition, there's really good friendship, we're doing something we all enjoy, and we're doing it all in a beautiful place.
Steamboats once ruled the waves here, battling each other over both leisure and trade, and a healthy sense of rivalry remains.
They've got spanners out on this boat, they've got spanners out on Sulaven, and they've solved an issue, so... Every regatta, somebody's got an issue of some sort. I've never been to a regatta where every boat has run flawlessly.
With his perfectionist polishing, Nigel has twice scored success. But with capricious judge and local hotelier Nigel Way now arriving...
Another year old.
Yes.
Yeah, another year older.
He's nervous about whether his dreamed-of hat-trick is on the cards.
He's very consistent. He always decides whose turn it is to win and then justifies the judging to support that decision. If I was a betting man, I'd put money on Moondance. Sulaven might have a chance, but it's their first visit. Nigel doesn't usually award somebody on their first visit. They've got to put the effort in and turn up a few times before he considers them to be a winner.
With the boats all set for judging, this year's competition is beginning to build up a head of steam. Later, while steamboat enthusiast Nigel Cooper steers his course for a gala gathering.
Dartmouth is an ideal site for a steamboat regatta, so it just all adds up to make the whole weekend a great event.
At Dartmouth in South Devon, the annual Royal Regatta is approaching a decisive moment.
There's definitely not on here, never won it.
Judge Nigel Way is casting his seasoned eye over the selection of steamboats.
Only slightly younger than me. That's not bad going, is it?
And Nigel Cooper and his buffed-up boat, Halcyon, are still in the frame.
It's beautifully brassed up, it's got its flags on. But you look here, we haven't bothered to polish our brass because we're more worried about our air pump, you know. So the judging is fairly subjective.
With no clear rules, it's a tricky competition to prepare for.
We polish every year.
I know you polish.
That funnel, that's embarrassing.
Yeah, I'd like you to win, but yeah, the funnel is embarrassing, and your good lady says it's embarrassing. Right, well, I've actually made my decision, and I'm going to go over in a second and share it around.
And this year's impulsive accolade of Best Steamship goes to...
Well done. Yeah. Oh, it's got to be Moondance, hasn't it?
Thank you very much.
Well done you. You have been coming for a number of years.
This should go in my trophy cabinet. I promise you it'll have the prize of place at the front, and it will look wonderful. Thank you very much.
Right,
thank
you. My pleasure.
They're worthy winners. I think they've got the best boat here today, actually, and that includes Halcyon. He's done well.
For the flotilla of small steamboats, there's another important trophy to treasure. That of time. Time to reflect on their living legacy, keeping afloat the manners and values of an earlier maritime age. And as they assemble themselves for the steamboat parade, Nigel prepares Halcyon and himself for a very special passenger.
It's all right to stand anywhere, okay? So you just go on what makes you feel comfortable.
Dartmouth's decorated mayor, Graham Webb.
Your first time on a steamboat, Mr. Mayor?
It is.
Ah, oh, there we go. Let's hope it's a pleasurable experience. Cheers!
Cheers.
Nigel's steamboat may hark back to a genteel golden age of travel. But whenever Cornwall and Devon meet head-to-head, the age-old debate of whose cream teas are better is bound to bubble up.
But it's got to be cream on first.
I'm not sure I can go that far. I think the trouble is with this cream on first thing is a touch of healthy eating here. Because if you put the cream on first, you only get about one-tenth of the amount of cream.
If you put the jam on first, the cream slides everywhere, often off
the
scone. Oh, yeah.
It's a matter on which Devon and Cornwall remain irreconcilable. But with this year's champion boat decided and the mayor safely back on dry land, Nigel knows the timeless power of steamboats can still pull people together.
It's what it's all about. It's having the company of people with a similar interest, enjoying it, comparing boats. To get the boat ready and go out by yourself, it's not that much fun. To come to a regatta, go out with other boats, socialise, have a few beers, a lot more fun.